Hey DJ, what's up, man? How you doing? Game apparently is a black screen. Interesting. One sec. Hey, Zero, what's up, man? Wait, did I lose the video signal? I'm doing great, man. Interesting. Sorry, guys. One sec. Hey, Indigo, what's up, man? How you doing? Okay. I apparently just lost video from the device, so that's great. One sec, guys. Let's go ahead and re-add this. Yeah, we're pretty sure probably everyone in the chat's well aware of who Pro Jared is. Best live stream start ever. Now, the funny thing, it was just working, and then it stopped working. But if this, it's gotta make sure you know what quality YouTuber you're dealing with. The fact that this broke immediately after I hit the play button. But yeah, let's just keep going. You see me there? Hi. Interesting. One sec. Let's fiddle with all our devices here. El Polo Loco live streams. Yeah, it's about right. Okay, we should be good now. Especially the massive number of accusations. Sorry, guys. Radioactive quanta extract. Quetacola. The drink for today. RIP headphone users. That better? Yeah. Sorry, I had to re-add the screencast stuff. I just made it fun.
Glad you had Toby move the first time. Always love on the crown of Menzel. How are you guys doing tonight?
Glue in the back of your seat.
Hey, Jeremy, what's up?
Again?
Well, yeah. Hey, John Bigno, what's up, man? These are all half finished. Alright. I appreciate the donation, man. Oh, Old Atari Gamer, what's up, man? This is like a typical Netflix movie? You mean in terms of, like, just the acting's bad and I'm just hanging out? Go like this. Interesting. I thought there was a vacuum fighting. The game, not you, buddy. No worries, I wouldn't take it as an insult either way. I have many things to tell you, and very little time. My mining is Bird Box, now on Dreamcast. You can't actually look at the game, if you do, you die. But, you know, play the game blindfold. You're the only one who can save us. I succeeded. Jeremy, how you doing, man? My world and yours. Through your computer, you can enter our world and help us. But in order to do this, you must transfer your soul. Yeah, it was funny. I was my wife and I watched this but hurry. It's like Innkeeper or something like that. It's some weird romantic comedy on Netflix, and just the acting is just so bad. I knew I could count on you. Now you must concentrate. This is like the eighth time I've played this. I feel like 8's a small number. But, I got a pile of games here we can check out that I actually haven't done. Let's see, actually, I did bring out... Let's just do the intro David Bowie song and make sure we get a copyright claim against the stream. And then we'll play, like, Time Stalkers for a bit. How about that? I yeeted my Netflix account after... Watching the Devil Dragon movie. Man, I haven't watched that movie in a long time. You have been the victim of a violent attack. Go home, eat, and rehydrate yourself. Mad Max, how's it going, man? Can't copyright me now if you're dead, David Bowie. You don't have enough material for a bad series. Just make a bad movie. Because a movie's only bad for an hour. A series is bad for a while. Hey, Telesplash Gaming, how's it going, man? Yeah. Yeah, and you guys watched that Another Life science fiction program on Netflix? Holy crap, that's awful. Like trying to sit through that. The only reason I managed to make it through was I was trapped on a plane going to Indianapolis, and just I downloaded it thinking, hey, it's got the actors who played Starbucks from Battlestar. I mean, it can't be that bad, right? Dear God, it was just droned on forever. Netflix has been bad for a while. Yeah. I'm trying to think of a series I watched recently on there that was pretty good. It's kind of funny. So there's a kid section. I have a daughter and all that. And there's a couple of like decently done like kids animated series on there that are kind of fun, worth paying for. But yeah, that's about it at this point. Hey, Ethel Chip, what's up, man? You headed to PRG? I am, actually. I will be there in October. Thankfully, thankfully we're not doing gunnery in that part of October, so I can actually go. Ugh. That's good. Yeah, I'd say, like, the actress who plays Starbucks is, Oh, crap, I forgot to grab the, thing. There we go. Oh, yeah, actually, my wife and I were talking about starting the new Dark Crystal, just because it just came out. See, I'm drinking a vodka cranberry at the moment. Yeah, Bloody Mary's used to see that in the morning. So we'll do the David Bowie intro song, then we'll move on to something else. Because, God, I love that in this game. Indianapolis isn't terrible. Yeah, you know, it wasn't that bad. I went out there, I was doing Master Cooperative Agreement training for the National Guard out there. It wasn't too bad, but I guess Idaho doesn't have humidity, so I haven't been around that in a while. It's like being hugged by like a big sweaty guy the entire time I was there. I've been talking about the death of your Netflix for about a year now. Have you played? No, actually, I don't have that one for Dreamcast. That bunny. Oh, Zero Master. I find like Netflix, like a lot of their stuff can be really hit or miss, but they're also producing a great deal of content as well. But yeah. But we'll find out, because it seems to me like at least Netflix stock value has always been kind of overinflated in terms of their actual value. But then I mean, Netflix has done a lot of stuff smart because they do have a massive subscriber base. I think they had an issue, last quarter where they only grew to 70% of their projected goal. So they still have a drastic amount of growth for a company that's just gobbling up subscribers. Oh God, yes, David Bowie should have been more games. Oh yeah, I heard about that. I heard about it, and I heard it was really bad, so I didn't even waste my time. I remember being really fond of Reboot when I was growing up. So I was like, no. But yeah, but I find Voltron on there is not too bad. There's this weird show called Three Below that I watched with my daughter that's not too bad. It's actually produced by Guillermo del Toro, oddly enough, but I'm like, that's kind of an interesting push. Oh yeah, one of my coworkers was telling me about the baseball card documentary. So I need to watch it. Netflix is dead after Disney ramps up. Well, Disney's probably just, honestly, like, since they bought out Fox, they have a controlling share of Hulu now. So they're probably going to go that route and just basically revamp Hulu with Disney Plus add-ons to it, because Hulu has just crazy simple account expansion management to it.
But alright, so that was Omicron Nomad Soul, one of the best David Bowie video games ever put to disc.
So let's go ahead and switch to Time Stalkers, a game I really haven't played. Let's do that.
Yeah, original reboot was great. I remember coming home from school, hanging out at a buddy's house, freaking Cartoon Network. It was fantastic watching that. You can only imagine how much that is. So apparently, so Mad Max, so the way, what I've seen is apparently for $12.99, you'll get Disney Plus and Hulu and ESPN is the package they're going to be pushing, so. Hey, Valster, what's up, man? Turn that down a little bit. But I can't imagine they would sustain that price model for long. I don't think so. Seven. He's brought back their cable channel. That's the Evil Empire. Now that, Disney, Warner Brothers, and CBS. God, I don't even start on CBS All Access. I don't know, I tried to give, I gave Discovery an honest shot, and I just despise that program. Like, my god. And then I tried watching, the Twilight Zone reboot they have on there, and it's, at least the episode I watched, the free one that was on Netflix and some other platforms, was, I did real bad. Yeah. Tubi, and that's free. Really? Yeah, I would definitely, like, I think a show about Lorca, I think, would have been better. But then they, like, even then, they managed to ruin Lorca by the end of the first season. Colonies of Grindelwald? I'm familiar with that one. But is that the one where it's, like, a reality TV show? Is that the one I'm thinking of? The Colony? Or a different thing? Thought, how's it going? Discovery's god awful, and I love Trek. Yeah, holy crap, Discovery's bad. It's like the entire show is run by writers who've never made a show before, is what it feels like. Where they're just so into that whole garbage, current generation TV that they just don't understand how to make a compelling story, and so they just try to push these like weird forced emotions, and none of them know how to build characters. How do you stock time? Stare at the clock. Hey, Kevin, what's up, man? Die. Yeah, I'm willing to give, aliens colonizing Earth. Oh, that sounds kind of fun, actually. Yeah, I'm willing to give Picard a chance, but we'll see. It's Alex Kurtzman's still got his grubby little hands on that one, so it's gonna be, we're gonna be lucky if that one comes off unscathed by that trash. But I was thinking, like, what it was. I've been trying to justify in my mind what it is about Discovery that I hate so much, and I think what it is that bothers me so much is that with traditional Trek programs, you have episodes you can return to, because even though some of them are episodic and they have an overarching storyline throughout the season, Every episode is still somewhat self-contained, and you have a problem, a conclusion, overcoming, and all that. So you have a story that's encapsulated where you can come back to it and watch it time and time again. And it's with characters, there's development, things like that. So characters were forefront to the problems that the story was facing. And they would expand with that. They wouldn't
go the other way. Where Discovery just throws all this garbage at you constantly, where every episode is just the end of the world, so each episode really has no relevance to how the characters are developing, because they're just constantly dealing with these problems. Yeah. District 9, God. Wait, were the aliens in District 9 trying to colonize the Earth? That seemed to me like they showed up and then just became a transient problem. Yeah, very forced. Mob TV is trash. Which one? Yeah, Zero Mansion, what I find kind of funny is, like, watching Discovery makes me miss Enterprise. Like, it makes me appreciate what we had. Like, even though, like, Enterprise wasn't the best, it was still just bounds above what we ended up getting in Discovery. You guys get that experience this round. I always love that about Discovery when they have the easy. What's up, man? How you doing? Doing great. But yeah, like when the robot chick dies in Discovery, you're like, who is she? Like, she was in the background of a bunch of episodes. And didn't even have, like, a speaking role in just about any of them until, God, that was awful. That was just an example to me of, like, how bad the writers of that show are. Feeling about this. Seven to nine is all I'm saying. Yeah, like, Enterprise took a while to pick up steam. I feel like once they started moving towards, like, the Earth-Romulan War, I think they really had a shot at making a pretty good show there. Okay, that's interesting. I shouldn't come across as smarter than a scientist. That's one of the things I hate about Discovery, like Burnham being... Like, Pike had great moments. He was like the only character I really kind of liked by the end. Like, Pike had good moments, but then he would constantly be undermined by the fact that, like, he had the... What's his name? The first officer, played by Doug Jones on all the makeup, and then Burnham. He's constantly saying crap, and he's like, oh, I don't know about that. And they're like, oh, we should do that. And he's like, ah, fine, we'll do it. And it's like, come on, man. You're your own person. You need to listen to these idiots. Yeah, the Zindi thing was, But my God, yeah, the last episode of Discovery was just so dumb. In terms of, like the reason why they went where they did... They didn't need to do that because they had basically beaten the enemy at that point. It's like, why are they even doing that? No. Not prepared at all. We'll see what happens. Saga Joe led them during this timeline. Oh, jeez. Oh, here we go. Okay. Instead of the pad on the ground, that's the next floor. Well, I don't know, I feel like if they go 1,000 years into the future, it kind of potentially ruins almost all of canon. I feel like it's a D-pad to change map. Okay, interesting. That's kind of cool, like that one. Interesting. A little more camera action for RPG than I'm used to. You know what? I'd watch a Star Trek Xenomorph crossover. Ankle but not straight. So my only issue with Enterprise, I just feel like they said it way too early. Just because it was like, then they had phasers and all that stuff, and they basically established it in TNG. They're like, yeah, we didn't have phasers until like, you know, the late 22nd or whatever. They're like, ah, who cares? Ah, yes. Hex gets it. 3PS has to be one of my favorite consoles of all time. You see the Zoe Quinn Hurricane? No, John, I'm not familiar with that. Huh. A xenomorph and prize with choker DNA. That'd be interesting. That are doing in some sort of search type. Yeah, I find that Shatner does some decent documentaries about Star Trek when he actually doesn't. Like he did one, I want to say like 6 or 7 years ago, called Captains, where he went around and interviewed all the people in the show and talking about their experience as, you know, captains. thought overall kind of was pretty decent. It's like a talks to Sisko, Janeway, Scott Bakula. That's a cool looking sword. Looks like a shovel. But yeah. Don't worry, Yahel's not here. He's too busy at PAX West this weekend. He can't come get you. Hey, Colin, what's up, man? I'm waving to you from your phone screen, despite the fact I'm actually taller than you in real life. Yeah, I watched. Captains. Okay, let's call it Captains. Wait, have they eat food? Just too busy being short to get anything done. Janeway the war criminal. Well, to be fair, like, Sisko from DS9 was a pretty big war criminal himself when he rained toxic particles on a... Oh, God, a Maquis colony. The Maquis had basically poisoned a Cardassian colony. And so in retaliation, Sisko basically just went and, like, put a bunch of poisonous stuff on a warhead to make the planet uninhabitable for the humans on it. So the humans and Cardassians had to swap planets. He's just rattling the glass. That's how it works. Oh, excuse me. You and I fight as a military maneuver or war. I think it would be a small, momentary engagement. Oh, you know, actually, I need to go pick up Nightmare Creatures. It's not for not too much, not too long ago. I got, like, 40-plus games for my Dreamcast, but those are the ones I don't have. She me-tooed an indie dev, and whoa. Did not know about that, John. Oh yeah, when Sisko punched Q, he's like, "Carb never hit me." What indie dev, John? Do you know? Daytona Dreamcast broke my heart. Actually, never played that one. Like do 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 do. Do. Oh, God. Well, I'm sure Jimmy will show up here later, and we can talk all about Pol Pot. The fact he's a history professor and all that. I'm not sure where I'm going. I'm just kind of wandering aimlessly. I've been looking for you for quite a while. Ah. I guess the one true religion of Star Trek. Didn't seem to become the commissioner of baseball. No, he did a thing where he put on a baseball game between his crew and a Vulcan crew. But yeah. Mine now, take this. The baseball one's the worst one ever. Take me out of the holosuite, okay. I don't know, I think the worst Star Trek episode ever would have to be the one where they're sucked into the board game of that species that comes to the wormhole, and like Quark is playing with the crew as a tamarane or whatever it was. I thought that one was pretty awful. Also there. Move along, home. The Elite Force is a FPS shooter for Star Trek based in, let's see, Voyager lore. On the Quake 3 engine, I think. Oh yeah, the one where Paris goes to warp 10 or whatever. And turns into a, oh my god, what was it? Like a newt. And then he abducted her. We're playing Time Stalkers right now, Colin. Sure. Leave the dungeon. Threshold. I didn't mind that one. I thought it was interesting how it kind of outlined this weird, still existing underlying racism between humans and Vulcans, despite the fact they're like the founding members of the Federation. They kind of hate each other in this weird way. But yeah, Jeremy, mad respect for knowing the name of that one random Voyager episode. Banner, Lizard, Children on a Remote Planet. Oh, God. The Two-Fix debacle. Oh, God, one of my favorite things ever, like, every April 1st, the Daystrom Institute subreddit does a whole thing of, like, a whole random thing about Two-Fix every April 1st. I need to check out Black Mirror. That show looks pretty good. So that's the idea. Is once you get to warp 10, I thought you could instantaneously appear in any part of the galaxy. But I don't know. I really feel like all they needed to do was just come up with adequate shielding for what they were doing to make sure you didn't turn into a newt. And then abduct crew members to have more reptile lizard babies. So I watched the Black Mirror Bandersnatch thing on Netflix. I thought that was pretty cool. Did you guys bring up a dumb Star Trek storyline? Okay, meanwhile, at the Hall of Justice. Mystery old man, you're a hero. Just yelling at you from all the way over there, that's kind of awkward. You're truly worthy. No, call me old man. Dreamcast, the only console that makes you abuse old people. Let me text Jimmy really quick and see if he's about. Yeah, it is gonna have a Master Roshi Yoda vibe to him. Mystical powers. Come if he wants. He was telling me he just doesn't get notifications for my channel anymore. So, crisis situation. It can give me 30 years in Seth MacFarlane, and I can finally give you a proper Star Trek. One of the few DS games or PC games I haven't played. Yeah, it's, I've had this game for a while, and I'm telling myself, like, I should probably check it out. What if Janeway somehow created the Gorn? That'd be kind of fun. Weird looking dude. Now it's an energy drink to keep me going. You're a sheep. I said the Dreamcast looked pretty good for the time. Still think it's a better console than the PS2, but that's just me. So Servant is a college mascot? That house is trashed. Star Trek book. I love how if somehow this game had the plot of Undertale in it. You have to fight your sheep. Okay, so he's like the save point. I think the lizard children would be a bigger deal than they end up being. Yeah, man, I think the only thing that really held the Dreamcast back in terms of, some of the really good games would have been just having an extra analog stick. It made all the difference. Monster House? Is that a tiny Dreamcast right there? So you can do some VMU stuff with that. It's kind of cool. VMU is such a great concept for consoles. Yeah, I actually have all my VMUs from when I got the Dreamcast originally. Playing the crap out of Sonic Adventure. Those pocket stations. I knew of them, but I never really used them before. So yeah, that'll trigger water. one of them freaky magic dogs. Uh-oh. Oh, I thought they did get released in the States. Well, to be fair, Janeway never really cared about the Prime Directive. She only really ever cared about what would get her home faster or in the right way. Or she would enforce the Prime Directive at a time when it was completely pointless. Looks like a golf course. Sega knew the Saturn hardware was not up to par. Well, the Saturn was kind of... There's a whole thing about that in terms of the Saturn was very much reactionary. Because they had the whole plan to be a great 2D system. Just insane in that regard. And then as soon as they saw the specs for the PlayStation, they just were like, oh god, what do we do? And so instead of... So over the course of a year, they just slapped on more chips and made the Saturn a 3D system. Going with the multi-chip architecture, which has made that thing crazy hard to develop for. It was pretty much the only company on the planet at that time that was doing any multi-chip designs with Sega themselves. So third-party guys were just left out to dry. Rude about it. That sword's his name. Yeah. But yes, like, the Saturn had a... I think Sega had some paths they could have gone down and make the Saturn a more viable system. But they're just like, meh, let's go this route and we'll try and get it out sooner than the PlayStation just to make sure we can secure our lead. Really bit him in the butt. Because he just sent out a bunch of dev kits and then no real dev kit support and just a bunch of documentation on, oh, here's what the system can do. Have fun learning that. How does get here? Saturn would have sold well on Planet Saturn. Yeah, it's one of the things that really bit him in the butt. Was the fact that just like, oh, we got to launch now. Savory apple. Oh yeah, God, Western developers were just pissed because they actually got the 32X dev kits, and then they got the Saturn dev kits around the same time. So they're like, what the hell? What are we doing right now? So they really were not happy with what Sega was doing. Gonna hurt. Oh yeah, I
go.
Yep, we're dead. Wah-wah. Okay, let's switch to a more action-based shooter for the time being.
Let's
Hey, Kevin Ball, what's up, man? Oh, Retro, how you doing, man? How is the barcade doing? Good to hear it's growing, man. Darkness has befallen. Megacity S19. Can't just call it city anymore. Gotta have destinations. Oh gosh, okay. Yeah, so you got kind of a seasonal thing going on there. I'll be right back.
Zero prototype shows all systems nominal. Guardian Chan, you are a go for assault on Comrade. And careful, Guardian. That's some expensive tech you're operating. Not one scratch.
Welcome to the industrial sector, Slave Zero. We've got to destroy this sector's communications array by taking out its three core generators. Once the array is down, you'll be able to penetrate the lab safely. Your first target is ahead 0.9 clicks. You'll have two more after that, so stay alert. We'll be tracking your progress from here.
Hey,
And we're back.
It's a lot like Astral Chain. Okay, missiles. This does remind me a lot of like Shogo. Remember that game? How do I jump? Okay. When this game came out originally, at least the first time I ever saw it, I got the entire game came out for free in Computer Gaming World on their demo disc. Because I don't think Slave Zero did particularly well. Yeah, I have the Code Veronica. I have that one for Dreamcast. That's about it. But I didn't bring it out to the garage where I stream tonight, though. Ooh. Oops. Again? No.
Slave Zero prototype shows all systems nominal. Guardian Chan, you are a go for assault on Comrade. And careful, Guardian. That's some expensive tech you're operating. Not one scratch.
Welcome to the industrial sector, Slave Zero. We've got to destroy this sector's communications array by taking out its three core generators. Once the array is down, you'll be able to penetrate the lab safely. Your first target is a head point. You'll have two more after that, so stay alert. You'll be tracking your progress from here.
I just hit him. There we go. It's so interesting, is like the Dreamcast, the way it handles the horizontal movement and the aiming. So the aiming is on your left stick, then the movements are your four face buttons.
which is a creative use of the limitations of the controller, but it's kind of awkward at times. I think Quake 3 is the one that breaks my brain the most. Unreal Tournament Dreamcast head. I'll use that control screen as well. It's kind of nice. I have the mouse and keyboard as well, and it seems to translate as well. I think Out Trigger is another one that's really awkward with the controller, but isn't as bad with the mouse and keyboard in the Dreamcast. Yeah, Slave Zero. Is this the Quake 3 end? I feel like this looks more like the like Quake 2. Play Need for Speed, run again on the 360. I've never played that one. Hey, John, how's it going, man?
You've got away with hardware, Chan. One target remaining, but be careful.
Yeah, this does remind me a lot of Shogo. Alright. Glad to hear you're playing your favorite console. It's mine as well. No, thrifting on Friday. If you want to collect for something, 360 is definitely one to collect for, because it's so freaking many. Oh dear.
And we have visual on the third generator.
Yeah, you're totally, yeah, Kevin, you're completely right, man. Need to go put on a 3DO with a Saturn or something. But how you guys doing?
Now when you're through enjoying the moment, proceed directly to the lab sector. We don't have much time before communications are restored.
Just no Splatterhouse, please. Downline backups. Shh.
Regulator squadron moving out.
I haven't touched my Wii in forever.
Dispatch is down.
That doesn't sound right saying that out loud. It's like I'm really been coming back to this one, and I really enjoyed this game on Dreamcast. Like, it's pretty smooth, gameplay's pretty decently. The funny thing is, the PC version I got for free, I couldn't quite get to work on my computer back in the day. To break the pad as well. Okay. It would have been better if they were ancient aliens. Oh, it was what, Ancient Human Civilization or something like that? It was the plot of Assassin's Creed. It's a big robot freeway, huh? Thank you. giving me a weird nostalgia. I haven't played this in 15 plus years. I gotta bust it out, man. Play it again. Got the PS2 games, server caps at 20 megs a second. Yeah, it's gonna take a while. Wasn't considered mainstream. Oh, Jimmy, there you are. You should hop on Skype, my friend. I was wondering where you were. I was hoping you'd grace the stream with your presence. Why can't I go back to resume? Let's go start. There we go. There we go. It's the sword for. There, man. Yeah, I got my Dreamcast not too long after launch, but my best friend, he got his, like, the day it launched. And I remember, I went over to his house, and we played Sonic Adventure for, like, I think it was, like, 15-plus straight hours or something nuts like that. Oh, that's cool. Look at the bridge there. That mouse and keyboard's compatible this time or not. 9999. PS1 and Saturn games. You know, for the one time I traded in games, it was Xbox 360. I was kind of poor at the time, wanted to pick up Kane and Lynch. So I traded in a couple of good 360 titles, and I was like, ah, cool, I'll do this, and I did that. And Kane and Lynch was so bad, I vowed never again to trade in games. I'm like, never again! It's a huge mistake. I don't know if any of you had the pleasure of playing Kane and Lynch back in the day. It's about a Dreamcast for the fishing pole controller. Perfect virtual fishing experience. Oh man. About a Saturn after returning my PlayStation because I was too dumb to know how to hook it up. Huh. No, I haven't found the fishing controller yet. I've been looking for it actually. So wait, so the Saturn? Or the PlayStation was too difficult to hook up, interesting. Kane Lynch series is fascinating. It had fans, but the fans still hated the game. I remember, like, when Kane and Lynch 2 came out, it had this weird shaky cam feature, where, like, no matter what you did, it was like you were being followed around by a guy with a camcorder. And when the game first came out, you couldn't turn it off. So, like, you were always borderline on the verge of just having motion sickness every time you played the game, just how they did that. Is this a really odd choice in game design? Proceed to SDO for transport. Let's see here. Did I send you? I'm pretty sure you sent me the fishing one for the PlayStation, I thought. A camcorder and Parkinson's. Yeah, it's like a. The joke I'm gonna make there and. Oh, I had Panzer Dreams Saga? Oh, man. That's always a bummer to sit back and think about. Like, for me, like, my greatest White Buffalo story is I was thrifting one day, and there was a Laser Active on the shelf. And they only wanted, like, I think, like, $50 for it. And this is even back when that system was still going for $400, $500 back, like, 6 years ago when I saw it. And I thought it was just a Laserdisc player, so I passed on it, not realizing what it was. Been kicking myself in the ass for forever. Pretty sure I sent you the Gen 2 and sold the Gen 1. Huh. Hmm. Yeah, I think I also have another fishing controller that I found for the PlayStation somewhere else. But I need to pick that up for the Dreamcast. I've always wanted to try that fishing game, because I have it for PC and it's interesting, but... Yeah, man. Dreamcast seems pretty hardy. Yeah, Dreamcast is probably one of the best built consoles I've ever encountered in terms of... It just keeps running. Like, I've had PlayStations, 360s, GameCubes, Wiis, all those systems have had die on me. But no, the Dreamcast, a system I have just run into the ground in terms of playtime. And the thing just still chugs along like nothing else. I thought, oh, they're in the closeout, when they're closing them out, $75. Man, I wish I had been smarter back then, because I would have, if I had really thought about, like, hey, these Dreamcast games are going away, because I didn't really collect back when the Dreamcast was going under. I would have just been buying up tons of it, because I didn't really get into the Dreamcast until, well, no, I was into the Dreamcast, but I didn't really get into collecting or buying games for it until, like, 2005-ish. And even then, I was just going after Shenmue and some other big titles. Oh, yeah! I heard about that. I always thought it was, someone was saying that the loud grinding noise is actually not the disc drive in the Dreamcast, but the fans, apparently. I feel like that's just part of the nostalgia for the Dreamcast, is that loud grinding noise. You know it's a sign of quality when you have that scary noise coming out of your system. Dreamcast has a port controller fuse? Huh. I didn't realize that, actually. I think I've always just kind of treated my PlayStation a little better. Optical drive is failing. It just keeps going. Laser can be crap. I've had to receive a few of them. Huh. Kane has an interesting backstory involving British history and military contractors. turn up the TV. Oh, is the game volume too low for you guys? Oh, it's a little Pico fuse, okay. I actually have like a drawer of those. Oh god, forgot my fingers. I have to like, as I'm so used to just the natural progression of this two analog sticks, I find this game the use of the face button really throws me off at times. But yeah, I think Slave Zero on the Dreamcast goes for like $2, something like that, if you ever wanted to pick this up. Not an expensive game, it's actually not too bad.
Watch your back, Slave Zero. Multiple inbound sentinels en route to your location.
Sounds about right. Yeah, I don't think anybody's in a rush to collect Slave Zero. Especially when like the game is coming out for free and something like PC Gamer and Computer Gaming World. Oh man, I freaking love the hell out of Tribes. I remember playing Tribes and it was just a mod for Star Siege. And they go, man, this game's great, they should make this into a game. And they released the Tribes, oh man, it was great. It's a myth that most people in medieval times had bad teeth. Well,
Slave Zero.
I mean, let's see here. I mean, odds are they probably had bad teeth just due to the fact that they were mulling and grinding flour with usually granite or stone-based, what's the word looking for when you grind it in. But usually, that ended up with a lot of ground down teeth pretty early in life. So they still had a lot of bad teeth, but not nearly as bad because they didn't have access to sugar in the same quantities we have now. But usually, like, if you were a rich aristocratic family or something like along those lines in that period, you'd have terrible teeth because you have access to all that types of high sugar diets. I don't know. He said a comment and made me think about it. But I mean, like, the Romans, for example, had a... At least rich Romans had pretty bad teeth, historically. So there's all kinds of factual stuff about dental bridges and all those things. I'd like to see those facts. Normalization of cavities. Let's put lead in their wine too. Yeah. I mean, there is also, like, you know, tons of lead piping all over Rome back in the day. Even in the United States, there was tons of lead piping. Until, like, 30 years ago. I mean, like, lead and paint, gasoline. It was a great little additive for a long time. Sorry, what game is this? Slave Zero. Freeway up the path here. Sorry, I was in the fight here. Wait, is that a hole I fell through, or did I fall through the map? Yeah. Heard the theory that it was autism that brought down the Rome. Well, no, there's really no link to lead piping and autism. There's a link between lead piping and dramatic increases in violence. It died. You have been killed. You are no longer alive. Okay, let's go so far. There we go. But I mean, like, the factors that brought down the Roman Empire, I think, were more than just lead piping in a couple of their cities. Because ultimately, just you'd have a lot more violent Romans if that were if the lead piping was really the case. So ultimately, you think violent Romans would have been the methodology to keep the Empire afloat and facing off against the Vandals and Visigoths and the people that eventually drove the Empire down. So lead pipes make people beat you. Yeah, basically. Lead piping has been shown to dramatically impact cognitive ability in terms of dealing with not being violent. It's like you. But you didn't really have the same issue in like Athens and Eastern Roman provinces, just because they had their piping networks were made out of. Not porcelain, but clay pottery associated things. They're designed in a certain way to click them together and seal them with batch of types. So it wasn't as common as it was in the Western Empire. There we go. Well, the Talk of Joe brought down the Roman Empire.
What did people in the 80s look... Why did the 80s look older in their movies? Was he really only 21? That didn't seem right.
Yeah, he served in Gallipoli in that movie.
Yeah, Jimmy, if you jump on Skype...
Ready for you, bro. Tonka the Terrible.
There's Tonka the Terrible's behind these things.
Dead. Hey, how's it going? Glad you can join us from Brazil.
All right, got an adjuvant.
Good evening.
How is it Hi. In Japan?
Aloha.
Konnichiwa.
Oh, it is konnichiwa, bitches. It's pretty nice, actually.
Oh, yeah?
It's not ball blazing hot.
All right.
So good. Yeah. I'm gonna see if I'm gonna tweet this out real quick, just see if we get a couple of people to hop on and watch. I don't know if anyone will join the chat, but we'll see.
It's the soy boy.
It's the soy boy.
Apparently that's what they
call
you that.
Y'all can't, you can't fucking fuck with my tofu. Y'all just jealous because you can't have as much tofu as me. Motherfuckers call me a soy boy. Damn right. I love my soy.
Oh, look, I love it.
I just love it.
I live it. I live for it.
I love it. I live it. What y'all know about natto, huh? What y'all know about natto?
I know, God, I watched, right, do you like natto or no?
I fucking love it, I'm not gonna lie. I just don't want to eat it in front of people because it smells like shit.
I was at a Japanese breakfast buffet at a hotel I was staying at, and these people were eating natto, and they're like, oh, you should try this. I'm like, I smelled it, I'm like, I couldn't do it. And they were just devouring it down, and I had to just leave, because I'm like, oh, I'm gonna go do something, you guys finish up the meal.
It's really good for your gut bacteria or whatever, your gut flora.
Maybe.
Yeah. I think it tastes good. But yeah, if I'm eating it, I don't smell it. But if other people are eating it, I don't want to be anywhere near those people. There you go. Jonathan's one of the proud soy boys. He's with me. You can fuck with my tofu. Got all the stacks of tofu. Y'all can't touch this. Well, Inigo Montoya, that hater. Mm. I'm not drinking a Zima, but I did get a Stella Artois,
ooh,
which I haven't had in a long time.
Yourself,
I got
huh?
a Blue Moon. A little bit. It's like $3 for a bottle here. A little small one, too. But I got to say real quick that you're playing Slave Zero, and that's a good one. I just love that you can step on people. This is like the evolution of Tonka Joe.
Okay.
You don't have to bulldoze people. You just go in a giant robot and step on people.
It's kind of how they finish it, yeah.
Belgium Zima. Brahma is the best. I guess that's a kind of drink.
Is that a Brazilian, I assume?
Sounds interesting.
Never had a... a question I have. How did the Dreamcast do in Brazil?
That would be interesting to hear.
Yeah, honestly, I've never
big,
heard
big
anything.
Sega. Yeah, right?
A big Sega stronghold, but never actually heard heard about how it did.
Well, you can find out next week on my channel.
I can't Stika, thanks, man. I really waited to cover that.
On the Master System. But how did the Dreamcast fare in Brazil?
I would watch the hell out of that episode.
I'd watch that, yeah. Yeah, it's interesting. Well, maybe we'll get I guess Paulo, I'm going to guess, is a Brazilian.
Yeah, he's from Brazil, so.
All right. Well, if you got the 411 on this Dreamcast in your nation, let us know, and then Ian will make a video about it with Stika.
I'll steal it, man.
Steal that shit. Well, you be the first one until Top Hat Gaming Man does one. So he puts out a video like every 2 days.
Or get accused of stealing from another guy who made a video about it like a couple months before me, despite the fact we had entirely different information.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm like, really? Really? I copied him? Okay.
Well, I heard that AVGN said this game sucks, so you're
So you're clearly wrong, because AVGN said this game was bad. I'm like, oh, all right. Oh, fair enough.
Yeah, even though he was making a joke. Let's see, top Russian bot YouTuber. I think Kevin Ball is a Russian bot, because he's always around. He always has the right words, right? He's always got the right thing to say.
Mm-hmm.
What is a cachaça? I guess that's another alcoholic beverage. Brazil leading an economic and military superpower would make far more sense in Venezuela and Call of Duty Ghosts. I guess then?
Well,
I don't know.
Yeah, I think it's a good idea, because I don't know. To be fair, people back in the day were like, oh, Venezuela is this economic miracle in South America. It's like, well, I mean, they are a mono economy, though, so...
Yeah, once your main thing fucks up, well, you see what happens. Pray for Venezuela. Hashtag.
Gosh.
You're into praying. Yeah, Brazil was supposed to be like this big superpower. I remember in the 90s. That was like supposed to be, oh, they're going to be like the third biggest superpower in now, right?
Well, I think they're going to, yeah, Brazil's still a rising developing power for sure.
Yeah.
Like they're going to be.
They can still do it.
They will be a force to be reckoned with here in the next decade.
Oh, I'm sure. Unless something really bad happens.
Unless the
Duploids come and get their revenge.
Oh, the Duploids finally rise up against Talk of Joe, yeah. They're like, oh, no.
Yeah. He was like a NASA a program. They sent him into space. He went to Duploid land. Dupluto or something like that.
It was weird. We wrote this program to like help this alien race out, but apparently it just ended up hating them. It was really weird.
It could. Literally shoveled them out.
Nice, man.
The streets. Yeah, Sao Paulo. Uh-oh, Kevin Ball, I think I'm onto him. He is a Russian bot. He's starting to sweat. I can feel his digital sweat.
And got him Brazil in the Earth Federation? Oh. Didn't know that, actually.
Oh, damn.
That's a
maybe you have to go back. You have to go back to doing fun Gundam videos.
Is that why the Xenon dropped the colony on Brazil? Or they dropped it? Where did they drop it?
I can't remember. Could look it up, though. Real quickly. Oh, I gotta tweet this thing out. Hold on.
Your laptop being really angry.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. My bad.
No worries, man.
It's always loud, so doing voiceover sucks too.
Oh, that must be. Thankfully, like I guess it's kind of the same frequency though, so it's probably easy-ish to filter out at times.
Yeah, I usually just, like, kind of record a few seconds, 10 seconds or so before I do a voice recording to kind of get rid of any background noise anyway, but sometimes the fan will kick up in overdrive, and it doesn't quite do it as well, but whatever. This is your background music. Can't hear it.
That's how I do it. I'm like, eh, you know, and I'll put a song in there and people can't hear it. My blue snowball, I had that problem. What am I looking for?
Yeah, they tweeted this out. Let's see what kind of degenerates join, if any. Okay, I'm gonna look up Yon Brazil. Oh, it's not gonna be Gundam stuff. It's talking about grass called Zeon. Oh, get out of here. All right, somebody will have to tell me in the chat. Tell us. Jimmy, stop watching all that hentai so I don't have all that background noise. Please, I wear a headset when I'm listening to hentai. I don't want my neighbors to know that I'm a disgusting degenerate. Yeah, Rio de Janeiro, city of God. I think.
One of these days, you need to go to Brazil.
On a
list of places I need to go.
There's Genovi.
Oh, Genovi, what's up, man?
Till in the fields. No, man, it's been a while since you put out a video, so I guess he's working. He's working on a Brazilian project, I believe.
What is it?
Has to do with a Brazilian hero.
Yeah, I'm currently working on a video about the Play Cable stuff, but I've been kind of slow going as his work's been so nuts.
Okay, the Play Cable?
Yeah.
So the
Play Cable was essentially like the Sega Channel, but came out in 1980 for the Intellivision.
Okay.
Pretty much a similar service in terms of downloading games directly to your home console via the cable provider.
Okay. Interesting.
Yeah, so it's pretty fascinating.
Is this going to be something that's you're gonna grab like a lot of interviews for, or?
No, honestly, I've been looking for people and I haven't found anybody. I found one person who's like, "Yeah, I used to work there," and I'm like, "Hey, you want to do an interview?" And then nothing, just crickets. I'm like, "Come on!"
Actually, I'm talking to this guy named Yahel, and I've signed an exclusivity thing with him.
I signed a non-disclosure until he's done with his project. I can't talk to you. Sorry. I'm like, "Oh, it's gonna be 2 years." Ah.
Yeah, it's 2 years in addition to the 2 years after he puts his video out in 2 years. So maybe in 4 years. Who knows? You might not even like video games anymore in 4 years.
Yeah, who knows? YouTube thing all dry up by then.
Oh, yeah. Oops, ISP, SegaNet on Dreamcast. Oh, hell yeah. I remember getting SegaNet CDs and shit in the mail. I think it might have had PC game demos on it. One of them might have been Omicron for some reason. I don't think they were Sega games.
I mean, Omicron came out of the Dreamcast, so.
That makes sense.
Yeah, I mean, the frame rate right now is pretty bad.
Yeah, this was a launch game, right?
Slave Zero? I don't know if it was or not.
Take 1 second. I think there were 19 games.
That was 13 or something like that.
Let's take a look. The definitive Dreamcast launch game guide. Oh my goodness. September 11th, 1999. Power Stone, Mortal Kombat, Soul Calibur. Spin. Yeah, I guess I think Slave Zero was one of the demos on the first demo disc. Maybe for the magazine or maybe for the actual system.
Official Dreamcast magazine.
Shit, Ready to Rumble was a launch game? I forgot about that.
One of the first times I saw Ready to Rumble was in that Chris Rock movie where he becomes the first black president.
There are 19 launch games. All right, sweet. Oh, you're 19? Talking about Head of State?
Yeah.
He's an alderman?
Yeah, that's the one I'm talking about.
The most realistic movie. Uncle Jimmy. Oh, those were a better time when we had CDs and the mail. Genovi's asking about Portland tickets. I have not gotten my Portland shit booked at all yet.
I already got my hotel booked. I should probably go and actually buy the passes.
Was it like $30 this year,
yeah,
too?
Yeah, it's like $35 for the weekend. It's never sold out before, but
yeah,
it's gotten more.
I might try to like get in for free, because I'm kind of a big deal. I'm trying to see if I can sneak in.
Just go stand with one of your buddies. Just like walk right, like, oh, I'm in the Metal Jesus crew.
Yeah, I'm pro Jared's lawyer. So fuck you. I don't have to pay.
Pro Jared apparently is on a comeback tour right now.
That's what I've heard. I didn't give a shit about the downfall. I don't give a shit about the comeback.
Well, I was sitting there and I'm like, I don't care. Funny. It's none of my concern.
It's really just none of my business. It's not, to me, it's not kind of fun. The funny thing was divorcing your wife on Twitter. But,
did you watch the video he put out?
Not at all.
He put a whole thing out talking about, like, yeah, they'd basically been divorced before that, and she decided to bring it back up.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was interesting. I mean, like, he had dates and timelines, and he, like, laid it all out, and you're like, oh, wow, he spent a while making this hour-long rebuke video.
Maybe he preempted this. He kind of knew it was happening, but she just struck too quickly.
Yeah. The interesting thing was, like, the internet was all, like, ripping the dude apart, and this was going down. And then the second he puts this video out, the internet's like, oh, we were all wrong, and...
Right.
Yeah, clearly he's the victim here, and I'm like, why didn't you think about that when this was going on, as opposed to just a giant bandwagon?
Because people are fucking stupid. That's why.
People love to hate things, that's just the way it is, and when you're on top, the whole world hates you. That's just always how it goes.
Jeremy, we're talking about Jeff Epstein.
Okay. Oh, we're talking about Pro Jared there. God. Steam thing, jeez. That whole thing's nuts.
Yeah. I was gonna say, you're doing pretty well at this game, huh?
Yeah, I'm doing good.
Sweet. Maybe you haven't had enough to drink.
I don't think I have.
I think you might want to chug some more beer.
Well, I'm drinking Yeah, the thumbnail's a lie. I'm actually drinking a vodka cranberry right now.
Alright, well. That's more potent.
That is true.
So why you hate the poor Saturn, Ian? Because it's just the tops? Fuck yeah.
Just the tops.
I can just see the Saturn. Yeah,
1930s?
That
Saturn, it's the bee's knees.
Well, remember, Kevin Ball, we've established, is a Russian agent. So he's just trying to find all the cool lingo.
Just Russian code.
He went on Wikipedia and looked up popular slang. The bee's knees.
The bee's knees. So how's your video project coming?
Pretty good. Let me see. I got like a fourth plus of it done, and most of the hard stuff's out of the way.
Oh,
so
nice.
It's just a lot of all this intro crap and story crap. You gotta manipulate a bunch of pictures and have to fucking record tons of footage, but it should be good. Should be coming out maybe tomorrow.
Oh, hell yeah.
So we'll see.
Excited.
Probably a topic not worthy of a 20 plus minute video, but hey, whatever.
Yeah, man, I could listen to you talk about that stuff for hours.
That's right. What do you hear me talk about? Dictators.
That'd be the best. Yeah, like, you doing your whole, like, professional stick while talking about Pol Pot or something like that would be just...
Pol Pot.
That'd be interesting.
Yep. Pol Pot hidden gems.
Like, did you know Pol Pot liked pachinko a lot?
Yep.
He was also a Gunboy Goemon fan?
Yeah, right? He probably was.
You're like, who isn't,
surprised.
Really? But, someone said, wait, there was something in the chat I missed here. Deadite, I once had a Dreamcast a few years ago. I had real games... Like Soul Calibur?
Smash JT!
What was it?
I'm just looking at Genovi, bringing up the Smash, the Smushmeister.
Oh, yeah.
The Smusher of JTs. he's the one having the scandal.
Does he have a scandal now?
Isn't every fucking video of his a scandal? Isn't his existence a scandal?
I don't know, something like that.
I don't know. I've only watched a few of his videos, but I know that everybody likes to give him shit.
Yeah.
He's got to be self-aware. He's got to be like a fucking pro wrestler character.
He's completely aware of it. Like, one of his videos, like the whole Pro Jared thing, he's like, yeah, I was completely wrong, but you know what? I really enjoyed making videos about this, so I'm not going to stop. I'm like,
yeah.
Okay. At least he's honest about it.
Right. Like, if he would be a little bit more over the top, he might be like the Alex Jones of like retro gaming on YouTube, where he knows he's a fucking goof. You know, and it's not all of his information is 100% bullshit. It's mostly regurgitated bullshit, though.
Well, my issue with the whole talking head retro YouTuber community thing like that is, like, the second any news comes out about anything, there's, like, 10 videos of people saying the same thing. So I'm like, okay. Ooh. I don't know if you've noticed that, but yeah.
I don't subscribe to them, but I know that people, once in a while, come up in the... recommended. I usually just say not interested, but I know it's an issue where it's like people share the thumbnails too for them, and they're all the same fucking thumbnail. Yeah. That's how I kind of know more about that.
No one should aspire to be the Alex Jones of anything.
Whoa. Ooh, fighting words. Who said that? Okay, Jonathan, I'm putting you on the list. I don't know what list it is, but you're on the list now, buddy.
Always invited back to the stream list.
You thought the frogs, yeah? To the frogs or something.
Yeah. The Sega Genesis Mini, it's out there. It's turning our kids into maniacs. It's out there.
Ninja. Ninja's turning the kids.
You got the ninja out there, and he's on the mixer, and he's causing the problems.
Now GameCubes are worth $40. What?
Okay, that's probably accurate. Yeah, GameCubes have gained value.
It's funny, they keep going down in value here.
Really?
Yeah, sometimes I'll see them. Like, you can get like one complete in box for like $10.
Really?
But sometimes you'll find them for like $5.
What about that crazy Panasonic one? What's that one going for these days?
Oh, the Q is like, you're gonna spend a few hundred bucks on that. I feel bad because I remember back in the old days when I moved to Japan, they had one in the back of all these boxes in like a video game rental store. They also sell used games, right? Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh, it's that Panasonic Q, and they were selling it for like $70. I was like, who the fuck's gonna pay $70 for a GameCube? It was completely in box, and it looked like it was like pristine. When I came to my senses, you know, it was there for like maybe a year or two. When I came to my senses, somebody had picked it up.
You're so, like, ah.
When I was like, fine, I was like, you know what? Fuck, I gotta get that cube. I didn't realize how hard to find these things are. I've only seen it, like, aside from like Akihabara, I've only seen it like one time.
Hmm. I don't get what I need to be doing right now. Break the glass on these things, or?
This is like such a like this era type of boss fight, right?
Yeah, it's just like what am I need to be doing right now? Like I broke the glass and these guys are falling out and squirming around like fish on the ground. So what do I do after that?
You're supposed to start up your retro gaming news channel. According to Polygon. Oh, that's not how I want to start a video. Oh no.
I get right there, Kanina. Oh, no,
you got Big Bat Alex here.
Oh, Alex, what's up, man? How you doing?
Let's see, first video after Pro Jared Defense was Rich of Review Tech USA, telling fans to not jump to conclusions. What? That guy's the fucking biggest hypocrite in the world. There you go, he outright called Pro Jared a monster in older videos, which are still up.
Yeah. Hey, I'm gonna pour myself another... Cranberry, I'll be right back. You don't mind entertaining the chat for just a moment.
Oh, if I can, I'll do it.
Oh, yeah, I believe you could.
Okay.
I'll be right back.
Ooh, Switch Hidden Gems. So hype. I'm going to have to get my newest member of the crew, Yahel Velasquez, to tell you about all the Switch Hidden Gems. Tell me about this Mario Odyssey. Playing Biohazard with the virtual twin sticks, nice. Kyle, I'm glad you loved all those Saturn things, because they're in better hands. You also got Guardian Heroes, which is like one of the best games ever made. IMO.
Justice for Big Cheese. You know, the next person who brings up Big Cheese in this stream is going to get fucking banned. I gave him his $200.
See if, Genovi, what are you up to, Mr. Man? You at home, or are you traveling the world sowing your wild oats, as they say? Tex Nexus 7, I can't stand Review Tech or Dreamcast Guide Trend Chasers. Yeah, if they had any sort of smarts or talent, they'd fucking be lawyers and be ambulance chasers, but hey, this is the 21st century. It is what it is. You got people talking about cardboard on the Switch for a fucking living. So, hey, God bless.
Oh, what I miss?
Somebody was just saying that they can't stand Review Tech or Dreamcast Guide, so I was just giving some opinions.
I just remember when someone posted Dreamcast Guy in the Dreamcast like Facebook group I'm in, and I'm like, why is this guy called Dreamcast Guy? There's not one video that even involves the Dreamcast on this entire channel of 1,000 videos.
Oh, he just stole the Dreamcast logo and sells merch with the Dreamcast logo on it. You know, it's like if I called myself the BTS Master and I just sold fucking, like, you know, merchandise. Here's a shirt from my video game channel, and oh, by the way, there's the cast of BTS. Whatever.
Yeah, like, thank you.
BTS fan. Yeah.
But yeah, I guess the whole talking head thing, I'm like, ugh. But other than Justice for Big Cheese, I did not rip off Big Cheese.
All right, no more of this Big Cheese bullshit.
Okay, what?
I'm gonna have to eat a hoagie.
What am I doing?
You know what? I gotta look up because everyone always tells me when Rich from Review Tech USA comes up that he's like thin now. I gotta see this for myself. I've not seen it yet. Okay, if I type in Rich Review, Rich Review Tech USA Exposed, Cucumber, and Etika. Those are the three suggestions I get.
Hmm.
Okay. Rich is still fat, but I guess he looks better. God bless him.
Oh, good for him. I know the Boogie 119 or whatever his name is. I know, like, apparently the internet's going after him right now.
When are they not?
Wait.
I always see that he died. What? Everywhere I go, Boogie died. It's kind of a stupid meme online.
Apparently I can hurt this thing now despite getting ahead of it.
Oh, okay. I see I do see the bar going down. Big shout out to My Life in Gaming for making amazing retro gaming vids.
Yeah, they're,
Well, I appreciate that. You're at My Life in Gaming. You know?
I really enjoy that.
Actually, you know, fuck, I signed in on Skype for the first time in forever, and I got a message from old Corey. Let me go read what it said. That fucker wants.
But yeah, I got a hotel in Portland. Ooh. I'm going to be staying at the, So I remembered, nice. I was talking to my wife, and she's like, why don't you just get a hotel? I'm like, yeah, I can do that. And she's like, don't you have all those points that you got from the Army when you were stuck at that Holiday Inn Express? I'm like, I do! So I'm staying at the Portland by the airport or whatever. Or the Holiday Inn Express by the airport, and like paying next to nothing because I'm using all those points I have.
Okay, so you're going to take like the tram down to the convention?
Yeah, the tram or whatever, yeah.
Okay, well, fuck, free hotels, free hotel.
Yeah.
Catch up on this chat over here. Alex is being nice to Colin. Stop it. 30 minutes of the video edited. Genovi, holy lord, that's going to be a long video.
Wow.
It's going to be good. Darkside Phil versus Review Tech USA. Fucking Teflon Phil. Darkside Phil. I don't know. He's entertaining as fuck. Let's see this over here. Retro Tink 2X Plus Framemeister. Oh, with the try, the mark impression, huh? Retro Tink. And I have to say that I think the Framemeister looked a little bit better in our tests.
Can you say you're all dirty peasants because you don't own a Framemeister?
Yeah.
Well, if you don't have a frame master, you're all a bunch of dirty peasants.
That's right.
Here at My Life in Gaming, we don't deal with the peasants. We want the best quality from our Tiger Electronics handhelds.
Okay, then.
I love those guys, though. So.
Yeah, okay.
They're nice, they make
awesome content.
Yeah. Yael is bringing his old lady. Obi-Wan and Jenobi may be my only hope. Jenobi gonna room together, we'll bunk. We're gonna hang out at the bunkhouse.
I'm bringing my wife and daughter, so.
Oh, yeah. That's good. Yael, I don't know, he was drunk when he told me this, but he was saying, like, I could stay in his suite. But he's going to bring his girlfriend, too. So I don't know how legit that offer is.
Oh, I think maybe you're invited to something.
Maybe he's a little bit of eyes wide shut type of creepy. Maybe the certain Pacific Northwest retro gamers are having a party.
Oh,
and clothes are optional.
That's exciting. I should be honored to be invited to that.
I mean,
you're the next in line.
I'm bringing you. No, I'm. Well, Yael is the next in line. That's why he's just trying to. He's trying to bring in sacrifices.
I'm pretty sure Riff from Pixel Game Squad is the next in line. Dude. Yeah.
I thought he was already part, and they kicked him out because they realized, nah.
I have no idea.
I don't know. I haven't heard anybody bitch about him recently, so I thought he maybe kind of like got involved in another. Oopsie.
Nah, I don't think so. He's making content.
Okay. Well, God bless him. Still wearing the glasses?
Oh yeah, of course. Well, actually, I think he's ditched the 8-bit glasses. I think.
He's got the 8-bit bow tie now.
Oh god. I think he ditched it and went back to the whole retro Liberty motif.
That's probably a smart idea, honestly.
Yeah, you're like, yeah, people don't associate with characters as much anymore.
Yeah.
I feel like, yeah, like, the time for, like, internet characters, I think, has kind of passed for the most part. I think people literally just want, like, genuine personalities somewhat now.
Yeah. It's kind of like pro wrestling when you think about it. You don't have, like, you don't have guys who's like, hey, it's Willie the fucking, I don't know, what would be a good W profession? Anything with a W. The window wiper. It was WWF's latest star.
I have an 8-bit bow tie.
Oh no.
They're just like, you go Alex home right now.
Gone full
think,
hipster.
Think about your life choices.
Got the thick rims, he's got an 8-bit bow tie, he's a game dev. Oh, he's got all the, you're checking off all the hipsters. I am shocked. This is like the longest you've ever played a game on the stream.
I know, right? I don't know. I just figured this one's just easy.
Are you enjoying it?
Yeah.
At least? Alright, because this game's pretty kick ass.
The only thing I've noticed is the slowdown when like you get flooded with a bunch of enemies. But other than that, it plays pretty decent. It's also crazy dark, but that might just be the HDMI cable I'm using right now.
Excellent. I was looking up those Dreamcast launch games, right? And one of the launch games was Expendable. Do you remember that game?
No.
It's like a shooting type game or an action shooting game. I don't remember ever playing this. I remember seeing it. Maybe somebody in the chat has some experience with this.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever played that one.
I'm looking at the box right now, and it's over 20 levels of adrenaline-filled action combat, cutting-edge 3D graphics engine.
Wait, is Expendables the one where it's like that almost on-rails type shooter?
I think it's kind of like one for the PlayStation. Let me look up a video real quick.
I feel like it's like you're on rails or something like that, and you're going down a path. I could be wrong.
Okay, well, it's got two-player co-op. In your face sound and graphics. You can tell this was made like in the late 90s.
Yeah, late 90s.
Right? It's got so much attitude, but it's from Rage Software. That's interesting. Take a look at the chat real quick. Expendables good. It's like a top-down Contra. There you go. Yeah, I was thinking it was like kind of like 1. I don't know if you ever played 1 for PlayStation. I thought it was a really fun game, but the second level was bullshit. Are video game hipsters people who only play on real hardware on a CRT? Ooh! No comment for that one. I don't play on a CRT, so... Ian, that might hit a little bit close to home.
Well, I mean, I have...
And Alex says yes. Oof.
I have 4 CRTs out here, but I'm playing on the 4K TV hanging from the ceiling, though.
Mm. Just rubbing that setup.
It's just
my wounds.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, I got, like... Sounds nice. I freaking love my garage setup. It's so nice. The only thing I dislike is the fact that, like, it's been, like, it was 98 today, so my garage is still kind of warm.
Okay.
But, eh. So I'm sweating a little bit, but whatever.
Do you have any sort of, like, portable air conditioner you could put in there, or that's not super loud?
Yeah,
I guess is the main thing.
Yeah, nothing that wouldn't just drown out anything I said with... Sorry, guys. Oh. My comfort's more important than you guys hearing me talking about the game I'm playing. I'm sorry. So, dang. Yeah.
Look at this guy, man.
this fucking guy.
See, people are successfully affecting demonetization by saying Monday Matt mass flags them. Holy. Dean Matt, man, why won't that name just go away?
Is he even still like? Is his channel still running or is he gone? I haven't heard about Monday Matt in forever.
I think his channel is either still going down or stagnant. Who knows? Hmm. My name is Monday Matt. Yeah. That man is a. I don't know, man. I don't want to say anything mean about him, so I'm just going to say nothing.
In case he's listening.
In case he's listening and he wants to do a collaboration, you know?
Oh, yeah.
You got to keep things open. That's the Smash way.
Yeah.
Actually, the Smash movie, let me talk shit about Monday and Matt, and then, hey, man, I just joking, you know, I'm glad that you talked to me. It shows that you have real character. Hey, you want to collab? Want to give me a shout out?
I remember, like, back when,
John
Hancock had that, like, get off my lawn moment.
Talking
about there being too many YouTubers and all that, and then, like, he ended up doing, like, an apology tour, so he was on, like, Smash JTV, this channel, doing a live stream talking about it. Like, yeah, I got off work and I was grumpy, and...
People are still butthurt over that. Mundane that, it's unfortunately it's even lamer than that, Genovi. It's mundane.
Yeah. The stream still going for you? Mine's buffering on my end.
It's refresh and it's okay now. So mine is a-okay. See 7 people talking about Bray Wyatt, the Fiend. This is the wrong stream for that. You gotta go at wrestling with gaming. And there's no wrestling. But wrestling talk is permitted.
It was pretty fun. Like Yahel announced, he's like, "Yeah, I'm doing my absolute Rose Street stream." And I'm like, "Wait, you're doing that? Like right now?" He's like, "Yeah." I'm like, "Can I join?" It's like he's jumped on with him.
Oh, sweet. When was that?
I think it was last weekend.
Oh, okay. I didn't see anything pop up. I might have been.
I don't know. YouTube sleep. Is weird.
You know what's just funny is, like, I looked today, and your stream was actually on my sub screen and my home screen. So, yeah, that's been a while, so.
Mark it up. Come on. Hop on the chair, come on. There you go, girl.
You little doogie.
Yeah, she's getting in her chair. Let's see if I can drag her over and get... Now that camera's cropped off there.
Oh. Yeah, just don't put your head under the chair this time.
Yeah, I felt so bad. She was laying on the floor and she just tucked her head under the edge of my chair, so I leaned forward and pinched her a little bit, and she like jumped up and knocked my mic stands over. I'm like, oh god!
Just be glad you weren't playing like a FPS or a fighting game. You know how people get real animated when they're losing?
Oh yeah.
Got up real... Ooh.
Yeah, fine.
We're now following that. Ooh.
tend to be pretty relaxed when if I'm like, I only like search screaming obscenities if I'm playing like an FPS like by myself and not live. My mic isn't live.
Right.
Yeah.
It's like, oh fuck, that sucks. Yeah, if I'm talking to a friend, I'll like do it just for theatrics. Like, I remember when I used to play Street Fighter 4, I would just curse up and scream a storm. Just, you know, just for theatrics. But when I was playing with somebody I didn't know, no mic, I don't give a shit. Mm. FPS is, I think the only game that I would scream alone was when I would play, like, Dark Souls. Maybe Dark Souls 2, because the hitboxers are a little wonky on it. Mm-hmm. Other than that, it's like I play video games to have fun.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and if a game's bullshit, I don't want to play it, so.
Very true.
That's why I don't play a lot of NES games.
Yeah. I'd say it was interesting doing the Overwatch tournament with Boise State out here.
Okay.
They are utterly obsessed with the... How the heck do I get through this part?
Some very dark looking, it kind of reminds me a little bit of like MDK2.
Oh yeah, that third person shooter aspect, yeah.
Dark, but cool though. That was a cool series.
I can't get there.
I think the MDK2, they put it on Dreamcast, right? Or,
yeah.
I remember playing a demo. I might actually own it, but maybe I never played through it.
Yeah, it's on Dreamcast.
Nice. I want thought to be added to the Webster Dictionary. Well, maybe in a few years, when we're in, like, the Idiocracy.
The greatest minds of our time are dedicated to curing male pattern baldness.
And curing erectile dysfunction.
Such a good movie.
That's like, little details that are, like, you know, everybody has, like, really nice long hair. Like, if you miss that first part of the movie, you will know, like, why does everybody have, like, long, like, extra in Conan the Barbarian hair?
Yeah, actually, I did... Come to think of it, I actually just now noticed that. That's actually a really clever nod in the film, if that's the case, like, why everyone has all that hair.
Like, pretty much every dude has, like, really long, nice hair, right? With the exception
of the one guy with the crossed eyes, who's on the president's council.
Yeah, and I guess Frito, is that his name? He just had nice hair. Jealous of his
like,
hair.
I like money.
Wait, you like sex and money? I guess Kevin Ball just finally got the stream to work for him again.
Oh, weird.
Gotta hit that refresh.
Yeah, I noticed, like, as soon as we had that problem, like, we dropped from, like, 20 down to 12 viewers.
Oh, that sucked.
Yeah. Such is my YouTube career. Many opportunities for success squandered by me. I wouldn't have it any other way. But I am excited. I'm going to go, I think the big old camera that I'm borrowing from my army job to learn it, I'm going to take that up to Table Rock tomorrow and do some shooting with it. I think it'll be fun.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, because the cool thing is the play cable platform I talked about, actually, like, Boise was one of the first initial launch markets for it. So I can include Boise in the background.
That's right, you were telling me about that. That's right. Interesting. So that was the same thing. I'm sorry, the play cable just sounds so, sounds like something they're trying to sell for your GameCube these days.
Mm-hmm.
Giving free to all the YouTubers.
They're like, hey, buy the play cable. It's the only way to get the best HDMI signal out of your, GameCube.
Yeah, I think these, like, Eon, these companies, you could probably have, like, 500 subs and ask them for a cable and they'll send it to you. Third World Internet. I'm sorry that. Is this in Russia or in Trinidad and Tobago?
A gigantic freaking praying mantis just landed on the webcam cable.
Joe,
like, nice.
Cool. You should flip the camera around if you have a chance. Take a look.
Hmm. Let's see if I can show you guys. Hang on.
2010 one of the rear selfie. Oh, that's terrible.
They do have their words of the years, and they're always something terrible.
You see it right there.
I'll see. Oh, wow. It's a brownie.
It probably didn't look right, but yeah.
I saw it. Well, that's kind of cool. Those are some pretty badass bugs.
Refresh this guy here. Refresh my own stream here. That's a... Oh, I guess if it's green, it wouldn't have shown up on the webcam. Because it's a
thermal game. That would have been funny.
Oh, wow. Now the background coloring is all messed up. One sec here.
I'll be right back.
Matt, do your thing. Fix something really quick. There we go. Look a little better. Yeah. See, Joaquin has lost 52 pounds to play the Joker. Oh, wow. Kind of like how Christian Bale lost all that weight to play the... In The Machinist. Play Taxi Driver. Oh, Crazy Taxi? Or Taxi Driver starring Robert De Niro. Yeah, actually, I didn't grab Crazy Taxi. I should have brought it out. Crazy Taxi. Actually, it's not out here right now, unfortunately. Let's see how this remake of the ship. That's a good question. We're probably just like, I think it's the best we can do. We need games. Get them out the door.
Indeed.
The game punishes you for not playing fast enough.
But he will not survive.
Something about that robot reminds me of the Rise of the Robots guy. Maybe his face. Yeah.
Little bit.
It's like really buff Rise of the Robots, dude.
Yeah.
I remember this era, people talking about frame rates in the chat. I remember back, I think the PS2 era was when 60 frames per second was like the standard for a lot of people. It's like, if it isn't 60 frames per second, fuck it, I'm playing it. And then I think once we got to like Xbox 360, PS3 era, and like PC could do amazing frame rates, and the consoles are kind of like, oh yeah, 30 frames. People will suddenly stop giving a fuck.
Yeah. I want to see like most Dreamcast games, I think, were like 60 frames, weren't they?
I think a lot of them were.
Yeah.
I know that Jet Set Radio wasn't, because you play it now. It's like, whoa. That's still fun, though.
Yeah, it still looks really good on the Dreamcast as well.
Yeah, I think Dreamcast games look pretty great. I think Dreamcast was the first time I noticed, you know how they have like the textures, like the depth of field, and they would like, you know, they'd be like little like, you could kind of see the rings of where the textures get blurrier and less detailed. It was very apparent on a lot of Dreamcast games because they were so sharp, right in the very front of the, you know, in the, what do you call it? Where the characters were or whatever, the camera,
mm-hmm.
The field, right in the very front, and then...
Yeah, let's see what else we can play here for a minute.
Progressively blurrier.
Yeah, Centipede, Sega GT, Cop.
Yeah. I heard PS3 had a lot of problems because of the Blu-ray format.
Put on some Sonic Adventures just for a minute. So that's a fun one.
That's right. Are you saving your games in these, or are you going to go from the beginning?
I should save these at some point in my life. Save the progress from these.
Let's get this man a Dreamcast extended memory card, everybody.
You know, I have them upstairs. I guess I thought, like, I was like, I should grab those, and then I just completely forgot about it.
Eventually, one day we'll beat one of these games. Like, Machin X, I think, is a game that you've played a million times.
Yeah.
And had you been saving and, like, continuing? Like, Berserk is the same way. Okay. Berserk, you beat that game in, like, a couple hours, right?
Yeah.
But yeah, had you been saving, oh, you'd have so many completed games under your stream belt.
Mm-hmm.
So many notches.
What's funny is the stream is 4x3, but the TV isn't actually stretching this to a 16x9 ratio.
Okay.
And I like that, because I'm a monster. But apparently everyone else has issues. They're like, you're sick bastard stretching that 16x9.
You are a monster. This is why My Life in Gaming doesn't come around to these streams.
That's why. it was funny when I did a video for I did a video for Genovia where I was playing Virtual Racing. And Bob RGB or whatever. The cool kids, it's all 4x3, and I'm like, a big cyber bully.
Guy's a fucking bully. Bob Neal.
I have a CRT.
Texture mid mapping. MIP mapping. Yeah. Well, I learned something new today. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Dude, I watched this intro so many times. Like, when I moved from Hawaii to South Carolina, I had this and Soul Calibur, and I think I got Power Stone. And I had that for like a month. That's all I had, because we didn't have any of my shit, because it was being moved over the sea, over the ocean, and then just, you know, slowly driven across country. Yeah. So I had a tiny TV that we borrowed from a friend, and I had like a Dreamcast with three games. And I played the shit out of Sonic Adventure.
I remember.
And I think
they had. Oh, sorry, go on.
I was gonna say the first time I had some quality time with a girl alone, and I was like, "Yeah, let me bring my video games." So I brought my Dreamcast and played Sonic Adventure with her. And me being a dumbass didn't realize, like, "Oh, I don't think these girls really want to play video games." I think it's like, you know, Netflix and chill back then. It was code word. Yeah, bring your video game over to my room. Okay. And so I played Sonic Adventure and she fell asleep. And this would happen again in college. Where the girl's like, yeah, let me watch you play Mario. And it's like, oh my god, this fucking retard. He actually is playing Mario. She fell asleep too. Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
I think I might be a little bit brain damaged, but.
No,
yeah,
I mean, it's like, you know, just priorities, man. Priorities.
Yep. Dreamcast controls over hoes.
Remember, back when I used to play Lineage 2, like, you had to get in, like, big groups of, like, 9 people in order to do, like, these XP runs in the game. And this one girl was like, hey, I want to hang out. I'm like, well, you see, I'm in this thing, and this took me forever to get together. So if you want to hang out, you got to come here, and I'm going to play this game if you come and hang out. That's just how it's going to work.
I'm looking at the chat. Everyone's getting all technical about that PS3 optical disc. Yeah, 12 megabytes per second guaranteed. Xbox 360 was 25 megabytes. That's why so many games, they made them on Xbox 360, poor ports on PS3. Yeah, like the first 3 or 4 years of like that era, Sys console wars or whatever. I do like the PS3 though. I did choose the Xbox.
Yeah, it would be Xbox initially, and I didn't end up getting a PS3 until Heavy Rain came out.
I think we talked about this, but I did the exact same thing. That was the first game I got on the PS3.
Didn't realize you could die doing that. That's cool.
Oh, Let me watch it. Let me catch up on the screen. Yeah, I played through Heavy Rain. I got the best ending somehow. No guides. I did reset the game one time when I accidentally shot the guy who was had a cross. And I was like, oh shit! He had a cross. It wasn't a knife. The only time I reset was that scene. And I kind of, because I felt bad. But other than that, I was like, oh shit, I got like, the best ending. John Goodman's the killer.
The first time I played it, I accidentally got the FBI agent crushed in the car, and I was like, oh, whoops. Oh, and I'm like, wait, no do-over? Oh my god.
That's pretty cool though, right?
That was interesting. That was really like a really jarring thing where the game was completely unforgiving like that. I'm like, that's a cool concept.
Yeah. FBI guy, like when he fights John Goodman at the end of the game, I actually helped him up and he tried to kill me again. I was like, oh shit. I think I got a trophy and it was called A Simple Mind. And I was like, ooh, this game fucking hates me. They're making fun of me for trying to save John Goodman. I think in Mr. Ziada, instead of Sean, it might have been Jason.
Jason.
Oh, Jason. Just because of that great Mega 64 skit about it. Cracks me up to this day.
That's funny.
That was actually when they really stepped up their production and it looked like the game.
Mm.
He's trying to give like this guy his money for a hot dog and he keeps like putting it back. Like he's like, I don't the button down enough. Oh, it's such a
I'll have to watch that one again.
Yeah. It's worth it. You have to scroll through like a billion different, if you go to the channel, you have to scroll through a billion podcasts, but it's not for the search function.
Yeah, they haven't been making it as many, they were doing that like BBC cell thing in 5 minutes, something like that, and something else.
Yeah, it was a few years ago, I remember. I feel bad, but I had to like unsubscribe because there were just so many podcasts, and I think I listened to a couple, and I was like, oh, these are pretty good, but...
I've been subbed to them for a long time, and I have yet to watch a single one of their podcasts.
Yeah, they're pretty good, from what I've seen. This is like a few years ago, though, but I was like, I just can't deal with the onslaught of Meg64 podcasts every other day. I'm pretty sure now. I should be subscribed. Nowadays, I'm not paying for shit. My feed. You know?
I find no, myself now, I'm subbing to more channels just so I actually have stuff on my feed. A lot of the retro channels I used to watch, like they're just not producing as much, but I think maybe they just have given up, or I don't know.
Yeah. I don't know, I feel like I'm kind of out of that area. It's like, you know what? Maybe once a year. I don't know. This is kind of like us. It's fun and all, but... Oh shit, just watching program. Beyond Two Souls, the funniest game ever. I've seen some funny fucking clips of Beyond Two Souls. With them fucking with the animation.
I always enjoyed that game.
Yeah, I like the Sonic. I like the music in this game, maybe except for Tails' theme song, which is that I wanna fly high. Something like that. I always feel like awkward. That's the kind of song where you don't want like your friend or your dad or somebody to be around while you're playing the game. You're like, what is this crap? It's Sonic! This is really upbeat. Yeah, right? It's like I'm starting to sweat. Oh, what I swear it's a really cool game.
What's the racing game on Saturn? That one's got some weird music in it.
Daytona,
no,
USA?
No,
Sonic R. Yeah, right?
Yeah, that one's got some interesting music.
I know what you mean. I'm trying to think of like Supersonic Racing. That song was so fucking popular with nerds. That was like the kind of song people wanted in like Dance Dance Revolution. It was so popular. Yeah, that was a Traverse Tales, I think, developed that game.
No. Dead. Shit, nice, no to go.
Sorry, right. Oh! Saru Maru?
Oh, nice.
I believe. Oh, that's nice.
Nice, yeah.
You got raided by a bunch of weebs. Mm. You're welcome here.
I like Sotomayor.
You are playing the perfect game. I guess he's, I saw earlier he was streaming his 16-bit platformer or something.
Oh, is it 16-bit? He's doing more, TurboGrafx.
It was, I think it was a 16-bit collection, platforming games or something like that.
I need to go around the back here. I don't remember.
That's good. I guess it just got done. Yeah. Sorry. Sorry, I was a nice guy. Unfortunately, I don't think he's going to Portland this year.
Oh, is he not? Is he gone to bat?
I think he's just, you know, it's probably money and work. Not having hours. He went last. He went the last time when I was there. Oh, sweetheart.
Oh, did he go?
Yeah, he gave me the Yuki stuff, and I was like, oh, that was unexpected.
Yeah, it would've been nice to have met him.
Yeah, we didn't have a chance to really hang out. And when I did see him, the few times I did, he did come to the panel. Of course, you were in the back handling the baby.
Yeah, my daughter just had a meltdown. I'm like, oh, bad day.
Yeah, but yeah, I was hoping to hang out more, but you know, he lives in Vegas, so either way, if I go back to the States, I'm gonna hang out with him.
That's our mod right there.
Uh oh.
I mean, hi, man. How's it going, man?
How dare you? Yeah, Jet Maxim, I gotta agree. The Sonic R soundtrack, pretty damn good. The game, not so much, but it's one thing about Sonic games. They always have pretty good music. Corny.
I'm still disappointed in how weird right, Sonic Forces was.
Yeah. I've not played it, yeah. I just know that my friend Matt got a lot of shit for saying that Sonic Forces is better than Sonic Mania.
Oh god, freaking video game donkey, the guy with like a couple million subs, that, like, I shit you not, this guy really said that.
Yeah, I remember he brought that up. It was funny.
That was pretty funny, like, this guy. I would hope at least he got a big boost from that.
Nah, not really. Oh. If anything, probably got more haters, man.
Yeah, that's a bummer, but yeah.
He's a unique individual, that man. I was talking to him last week. He's doing good.
Yeah, I'm glad he's making videos again. It seemed like he had kind of mellowed out for a while.
Nah, people got their reasons, but he's all good. Sonic CD port for the Saturn? Was there not Sonic CD on Sonic Jam? Was it just 1, 2, 3? I know they had Sonic CD movies on this fucking Sonic Jam Saturn.
Yeah, there was. Yeah, he had the intro on the GameCube version of that.
Sonic Boom. Yeah, the GameCube. And,
I think yes, the Sonic CD version was like pretty much by itself for a long time.
That's right. Yeah, they just basically Blue Cock teased you in the Saturn game. Take it easy, Gavin. Passing out. He's gonna go
later, man.
Go to his Russian office in the morning.
Yeah.
Well, since we have all these Saru people here, let's put in Sentimental Graffiti 2, the dating sim, and let's go and date the chick in the wheelchair, Konami. Let's do it. I got this the right audio.
Definitely would be.
Barky meeting now.
Come on, hop down. You can stand up precarious in the chair. I don't know what you're doing. If I could rotate the camera, she's just standing up in the reclining chair over here, just being a weirdo.
She heard about the Sentimental Graffiti.
Yeah, she's like, I'm
not. I don't like the wheelchair chick.
She's like, I'm not cool with that.
Super Boo 85. Howdy, everyone.
How's it going?
How are you? I believe he is one of the Saruites.
Yeah. This station must be the center of the city.
Chex Quest, the first PC game that you owned. That's I don't know if Chex Quest is one of those hipster games these days.
Well, I think the AVGN video kind of brought that back into relevancy.
Really? Okay.
Hey, you missed that?
I didn't watch it, no. I've not watched any of his newer videos in like a few years.
He has mellowed out a ton.
Well, yeah, there are reasons for him.
Yeah.
not just being a dad and some behind the scenes stuff, I guess. Mm. LGR, okay, I guess it's AVGN.
Still, I still have a theory that Super Derek is editing for him now.
Super Derek?
No, not Super Derek. Oh my god, what's his name?
As I say, it's definitely not Super Derek.
Yeah, not Super Derek. Oh, God. Wow. I'm having an aneurysm. I smell toast. You can't.
Having a senior moment.
Yeah. No, it's, this is Game Dave. There we go.
Oh, you have a theory, dude.
Yeah, that's my theory.
A game theory, huh?
A game theory. The Game Dave is editing for ABGN.
Oh, really? Why do you have that theory?
Just some fun stylized choices when he was doing some some videos that I'm like, that's awfully similar to what this guy was doing.
I know. It really makes you think, doesn't it? It really gets that noggin jogging, doesn't it?
Yeah.
That's a very interesting deduction. you may or may not be spot on. I think you gotta grab that little like orb thing that you saw at the house.
Okay.
And put it on there. I don't know which one you gotta do it for which though.
I haven't played this game.
Yeah, like... it's kind of like like Larry Bundy, right? When you'd watch some of his videos from a few years ago, it's like, this is exactly how DJ Slope edits his videos.
And you're like, oh, he edits. Like, oh, okay, of course. It's, yeah. But yeah, I didn't realize it like until Yahel and I were talking. Apparently, Larry was talking to Yahel about editing, maybe editing some videos for him. And Yahel and myself were like, really, he doesn't edit some stuff, huh?
Yeah, I don't know about now, but back then it wasn't like a secret or anything, but it was like DJ Slope and Kim Justice were editing all of his videos, and you could kind of tell which ones were which. Oh, there you go.
Hmm.
Put the Indiana Jones prop in there. Sanu Maruya, Game Dave. Yeah, nice dude. Yeah, he used to do a lot of videos. I used to chat with him a lot too, but he's a dad now. He's got a lot of obligations. Sad that he doesn't put out as much, but Dave's always been a solid dude, so it's a shame. But maybe,
was he involved in that multi-tap thing? Or?
Oh no.
Oh crap. Perfect shame.
Speaking of that, though, like last weekend, I was talking to all those people, and drama going on.
Oh yeah?
But yeah, Matthew Ezero. Oh no, did you just fucking die?
I did. I forgot you. On those parts, you just don't want to touch your controller.
Yeah, you just gotta keep holding forward. Also, I remember like the first time I played Sonic Adventure, that first level with the whale and everything, the beach. I didn't know you aren't just supposed to like hold forward on the stick, and I kept dying in that first loop-de-loop. I was like, what am I doing wrong?
God.
Is this the tornado? Oh, yeah.
I don't know if I died or... Okay, there we go.
Well, in real life, I think it's safe to assume that you'd be dead. You'd be cut up by all those bricks.
In real life, I'd be just, like, pummeled to death by all the debris in there.
Yeah, all those that debris would just rip off all your flesh.
Oh, my dog.
It'd be a spitting red mist at
that
point.
Yeah. Oh, jeez, yeah. One sec.
Oh shit, so Sadamaru is going to Portland. Well, that's just fantastic news. No, go for that. Yeah, we gotta do like a proper hangout. I was saying earlier, Sadamaru, before you were here.
Sorry,
I'd be in Vegas.
I had my garage door open. My dog was, looking at the driveway longingly, and I'm like, nah, hang out over here.
You're not leaving here. I know we're playing Sonic Adventure.
Yeah, I know it's not your thing, dog. It's okay.
Tell me where the furries touched you. Hey, come on. This is before all that weirdness, so. Though.
No. Oh, wow.
Every gamer and APGN should have worked together. Yeah, Mike Boutte, I don't know. Behind the scenes, he did a lot of stuff for Angry Video Game Nerd channel, so some people might say it was to the detriment because he fucked people over, but I don't know. It don't matter. It is what it is. We got 10.2, so.
Oh, yeah, that'll work.
Genovia, you want to heckle me? You should have heckled me at that last year's panel, because I ain't doing the panels ever again.
John,
you guys
Riggs
were all nice.
John Riggs is like, ah.
John is like, fuck that guy.
Keanu Reeves is like, this is the worst mistake. I get my own panel. And I invite this fraud. Joseph Fool 64? Yeah, I think the thing about James is like, yeah, he really just, his passion is movies, which is why he made the ABGN movie. And it's kind of like the ABGN thing is like the bread and butter. I don't think he hates it. I don't know what's going on, why he can't jump off of that. Maybe this is glitching out.
Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on.
Did you patch your game before you played?
Oh, you have to hold the stick. There we go. That's what we're
doing. Okay. Really?
There we go. You have to hold the direction. You're like, why?
That, I think it's supposed to be automatic, though. That's so weird.
Yeah.
Okay. What a nightmare.
I feel like Sonic Adventure is one of the better 3D ones. With the exception of Generations. Just
Generations, yeah, I got that on my shelf over there, yeah. It's good. I didn't play through it all the way, but I enjoyed pretty much all that I did.
Because I found like
few areas.
Yeah, so I found like Adventures, despite it being kind of clunky in 3D, it still gave you a lot of freedom. Where later Sonic titles like Force and stuff like that really just confined you to rails like, the entire time you're playing.
See, I've not played it, so it did look pretty sick. You know what? Sonic Forces, that was the one where it was like, bring your DeviantArt fucking avatar to life.
Yeah, do you they knew their market. Do you want to make a red fox?
Yeah, I want to make one. Didn't it have a weird thing, though, where, like, you'd randomly change your characteristics? So it gave people, like, it was, like, a cyclical thing, mutual thing, where it's like, well, you know what? I started off with my DeviantArt character, and then I started getting these weird bunny ears, and I got, like, a duck bill.
Yeah, you unlock more stuff as you go, yeah.
I thought it was like an automatic change to your character's looks, though. Like an evolution type game or something.
Yeah.
Okay. Either way. I guess it's kind of cool, but knowing what I know about DeviantArt and Sonic, I wouldn't let my kids play that game, I'll put it that way.
You stay the hell away. Oh, God!
Yeah.
I missed the thing apparently.
Oh, my God, yeah.
Yeah, is there wrestling? I don't think so.
Saying he's gonna make a heel turn. Oh my God, I just saw you die. That's sad.
Yeah, I'm like, okay, apparently I was supposed to fly to that.
Yeah. Metal militia member during the panel. I think that Yahel is gonna be wrestling with Nazism. That's gonna be his heel persona. Come on, you know it's true. How are you gonna get... That's the easiest way to get heat in today's society.
Knocking the drink girl. Oh, I can see the dog over here. Hello, dog.
Maybe he could be like, a Bray Wyatt type. Just let the CDI in. No. All you gotta do is let the CDI in.
Put that into your heart.
Yep. Pretty much. He's like a cultist. He's like a cult leader. He'd be perfect. If only he knew what he knows now, right? Oh my God! I just watched you almost get killed by spikes.
Come on.
That is just. Apparently, according to Seven Beetle Doom, there's some UK comics where it's super violent, and there's a Sonic Hulk that commits implied cannibalism.
Oh, that's fine.
Genocide. This sounds like somebody's fanfic turned wrong. Or right, I guess, actually. TexNexus7, congratulations, you just got banned from this chat.
Cool.
All right, I've heard of the CDI cult. Sounds awesome. Enjoy your ban. Won't be seeing you again, buddy.
Ah, crap! I read the chat. Okay.
Mario Andrade. Every time I'm drunk, I'm here.
Oh, fantastic.
Well, I'm.
But I feel bad. But we've been going for about 3 hours, so I'm actually gonna go ahead.
Gorilla Jones. No, I'm ending the stream now. Sorry, guys.
Intrigued Gaming here too.
Yeah, how's it going, man?
So one of Cyrus buddies.
Yeah. But yeah, definitely want to thank you guys for hanging out and coming in and being here as long as you have. I feel bad for those of you just joining the stream because
YouTube didn't notify you. Sorry about that.
Wow, it's pretty hot.
But I hope you guys have a good night. I want to thank you for dropping by. And especially thanks to Saramaro and his gang that dropped by to hang out.
Oh, yeah. Did.
And also thank you, Jimmy, for always coming out. Always a pleasure hanging out.
No problem.
Yeah.
Trying to get you kicked off YouTube, but it's not working.
You'll get us there eventually.
Okay.
But all right. Well, thank you guys for hanging out, and you guys have a wonderful evening. All right.
Later, guys.
Bye.
Bye.